fight it when they lust after a man.
I knew the exact moment with you. The hospital ball on the stairs.
Ha! Wrong. I hated your guts that night.
Yes, you did. But there was also a lust in your heart.
Oh, you've got tickets on yourself.
I was first brought in to talk about Patrick, or even the idea of Patrick, in like September of... It might have been 2009 or 2010 or something. It was long before we even started filming that second series. And they had ideas of, you know, maybe he'll work in the hospital, maybe he'll work in a real estate agency, but he's something we want you to play and we want to write with you in mind. Would you be interested? And to think where we are now from where we started, it's significant. And this character is very close to my heart, I suppose.
I seem to recall you lured me onto a fire escape and jumped me once.
You should at least be wearing more in the way of clothing, Patrick. There's comedy, there's intense drama, there's heartbreak, there's love, there's sadness, there's all the things that we experience in life that as an actor you hope to get the opportunity one day to express, but to be able to do it in one show on a daily basis is an extraordinary opportunity. So living with Nina as a character for four seasons, I guess, has felt like running the gamut of emotions every day that I play her. And, you know, I wouldn't be being truthful if I didn't say that it is sometimes it's a large amount of emotional output. And it can be a little exhausting, but at the risk of sounding ungrateful, which I'm certainly not, the privilege is all mine to work on a show like this. It requires a lot of stamina.
You know, we just shot last week some intense stuff that I've been thinking about for quite a long time. So that can, you know, you can get quite analytical about it and think about what you might want to do, but I think any creative job, or especially with acting, even though you are trying to sculpt a final product, it's the process of the sculpting that people are watching. So intuition is always very important. And this show has, we are lucky enough that we have an incredible crew that allow intuition to be probably one of the most integral parts of the show. And I think it works. I think that energy and that spark is what can either make the most honest, sort of dramatic moments, emotionally truthful, or can make the humour the most vivid. And what makes this show work is that spark.
You know, I think my approach to Nina has always been instinctive, as opposed to over-intellectualising things. I don't, as an actor, I don't think overthink things too much at all, no matter what character I'm playing. But certainly with Nina, because of her very impulsive quality, and the spontaneity that the show requires so that it can sing, bounce, I have to remain spontaneous and can only come from a place of instinct that I trust, I guess. So, I mean, of course I think and I prepare beforehand, but once I'm on set and we're in the moment performing something, the exciting part for me is I like surprise just as much as the audience does, so I sort of put myself in a position where... And certainly the people around me create an environment where I'm able to trust that whatever happens in the moment is going to be okay. There's something about Nina, it's as if she's stopped reaching for something different. She's sitting in a reality and she's happy where she is. She hasn't got everything working as much as she'd like it, because she's such a misfix-it. But she's just not reaching and holding on so tight. She's not reaching for a happy ending. She has it, she's in it.
Like, the fact that they're together, now they're together, which is one thing which we wanted. We didn't want to keep make-up, break-up, make-up, break-up, because I think the audience have gone through so much of that. And by now in Ep 10, we've worked out a lot of our shit. We're still going through a lot of stuff. Most couples do that. And, And one of the shows, what's interesting about this show is I know that the writers are acutely aware of this as well. They're trying to grow with their audience. So if you've got an audience that's now been loyal to you for a few years, you don't want to just keep rehashing the same types of stories. And you can't keep breaking someone up and then getting them back together and giving them the happy ending. So the show's, it's definitely pushed different, you know, these two characters into different sort of aspects of trying to understand each other in the knowledge that they're, you know, about to bring, you know, someone into this world.